Not my hockey mate. Welcome back to New Zealand's greatest consumer affairs show. Now, insurance hassles are one of those pet hates on Fairgo, the ultimate grudge buy. But when you need it, gosh, you appreciate having it.
Yeah, true. Well, one of our younger viewers, Reuben, needed some for his pet pigeon, Gary, but couldn't get it. So he called Fairgo for some help. Here's Garth.
This is Gary.
When we originally got Gary, we were told that she was a boy. But then when we got some more pigeons, Gary laid an egg. We decided to keep the name Gary because it suited her. But yeah, Gary's a girl.
So what happened to Gary?
Gary got sick, was struggling to breathe, and wasn't eating that much food. The vet told us that we did not have a very good chance, so it was more likely that Gary wouldn't survive. Gary went into an oxygen chamber and luckily got better.
There are no public pet hospitals. Amazing care costs nearly $500.
If we didn't have that kind of money, then we wouldn't really be able to help them get better. We would be absolutely heartbroken.
Reuben went looking for pet insurance for pigeons.
Just cats and dogs, cats and dog and horse. Tower, cats and dogs, cat, dog, rabbit and horse, cats and dogs, PD, pet insurance, cats and dogs, even though that as its logo it has a rabbit leaping into the air.
That especially bugged Reuben.
I just thought that it seemed quite misleading, so yeah, that's why I called Fairgo.
Reuben has a whole flock to think about.
Gary, dinosaur, that's Mocha. That's Bolt. Next to Bolt is Fluffball. Next to Fluffball is Crackers. Inside the food bowl is Ragnarok. And then all the way over there is Midnight, who's a little bit camera shy.
Reuben's story got us thinking too.
We love our pets. So is getting pet insurance putting a price on that love? And if so, how do we know we're getting value for money?
Love is walking the dog, even if it's a rainy day at the beach in Wellington. Rebecca has also made a study of pet insurance for Consumer NZ, comparing the major pet insurers on their dog and cat cover, what you get, and how much that costs per month.
Well, our survey found that premiums for a puppy from 6 months old range from about $25 through to $75. Some policies range from $9,000 through to $25,000 in terms of what you can claim every year, so it certainly pays to shop around.
And to review what you're paying for, whether or not you make a claim, because the insurer will be.
Every year when it comes up for renewal, they can decide not to cover you or increase the premiums or put more exclusions into your policy, so it would make it less good value for your animal.
Consumer found most of us would spend less than the cost of premiums on routine animal care, so there's less need to cover that.
So it's really for the big things, the catastrophes.
You insure in case the worst happens, so it's a balancing act, and it depends on your finances, whether you have got a little buffer there that you can access to pay for the vet.
Do you have pet insurance for Blue?
No, I don't. When I first got Blue, I looked into it for Blue and our cat, and it was just really expensive. So I decided to go without it, and we just sort of squirrel some money away. So we've got a little bit of a fund there that we can tap into.
Money isn't the only thing that matters if you have a pet. Remember Reuben's disbelief at the rabbit logo for the company that only covers cats and dogs. A spokesperson says it's not a literal representation of its service, but a symbolic representation of its brand values. We've caught everyone on the hop regarding pigeons. Pet Cover says it's about to launch insurance for any exotic pet that can legally be kept here, but doesn't have prices yet. Tower says it would need to do the numbers.
It's largely about how often a pigeon would need to visit a vet for an illness or an accident, and then what the cost of the treatment would be. And that's basically how an insurer would set a premium.
As for consumers' suggestion to put money aside instead of insuring...
Last year we had one claim of $7,000 for an emergency surgery on a dog. So some people will have that in savings, but a lot of us won't, and that's where pet insurance helps.
Tower does want to say thanks to Reuben for putting pet insurance on people's minds.
Hey, Gary.
With a $50 pet store voucher.
That's one little gesture we can make. Unfortunately, we can't insure the pigeons, but we can help them with that.
We sent word to Nelson via Zoom, not a courier pigeon.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, they'll be very happy. They will definitely go to good use.
Especially with so many beaks to feed.
Gary, get out of the food bowl. Other people want to eat food.
Good story. Shot by Gary, not the pigeon, the cameraman Gary. Two Garys on that story. Very confusing for Garth,
who's
not easily confused.
And fun fact, Garth tells us it's actually quite hard to work out if a pigeon is male or female.
Nothing gets past Garth. And also, if well looked after, pigeons can live for up to a decade.
Good to know.